I think there's been intense research, and just up to May, there have been more than 200 trials that have been registered for use of either current available or new agents for the treatment of COVID-19. Whether these centers are in the US, in Europe, in UK, or in Asia, as long as the trials are done properly, I think that we can look at see how they can benefit patients. So when we look at these trials and the treatment that are available, broadly speaking, we're looking at what are the antiviral therapies. That means the drugs that actually attack the virus and or reduce the viral counts. So that's one aspect of treatment. The other aspect of treatment is there's patients who are severely ill with COVID-19. Oftentimes, there's a lot of dysregulation of their immune system. And is immune dysregulation or hyperinflammation causes mortality in patients with COVID-19. So the most recent information or research that has come out was actually on the use of a steroid called dexamethasone to reduce hyperinflammation that occurs in the later part of COVID-19. This dexamethasone attacks and treats that part of the disease. It does not affect the viral part of it. You know, so there are various parts of how we can use different forms of therapy at different stages of the illness. There's one company that is looking at prophylactic antibodies. They have found from people who have recovered from COVID-19 certain areas in which you can develop or manufacture antibodies against certain parts of the virus. They are used either when you are severely ill with COVID-19, we administer these antibodies and then try to reduce the severity of the disease. But also, just as important, they are also looking at preventive antibody treatment, which is giving what we call prophylaxis. Like if you don't have a vaccine, you administer this antibody, and with this antibody circulating inside you, if you come into contact with COVID-19, it reduces your risk of getting infection. There's a lot of research, and there are a lot of things that researchers are focusing on, trying to develop new methods, both for prevention and also for treatment. I think that any victory against COVID-19 is at best transient. I think this virus is able to find all the hidden cracks and come back very easily. The take-home message is there's always a risk of it coming back. Once you open up, you reduce your lockdown measures or your circuit breaker measures, you are likely to see some cases occurring because there's always a very low level transmission within the community. And I think that that's important, that if we do get cases, that we diagnose them early and then we contain those cases and prevent a cluster from forming. We do expect to see a small blip in cases, and this small blip will remain small if everyone plays their part.